Hello, hello, hello. Good morning again. We should be live on the live stream as well. It's kind of pointless to tell everybody where the URL is, perhaps because they're watching already, but for those of you who want to tweet about it, nextcloud.com/livestream. As usual. So again, welcome. Really cool that you're all here. I have a few practical things besides a thank you. So we'll first do the keynote by Frank. After that, we have a break for about 30 minutes. There should be drinks then outside. And you can discuss all the cool announcements that we had in the keynote, of course. After the break, we start the lightning talks. That will be one people talking 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes. And after that, we have lunch. That will be on the first floor, on tables. After lunch, we have a second keynote. And after the second keynote, we have again a bit of a break, and then we go to workshops. The workshops will be on the seventh floor. There are two workshop rooms. There will be signs. Okay. So, that's the practical stuff. I guess we should get started. So, Frank, please kick us off today.
Thanks. Thanks, Jos. So... Also for me, a really big welcome. I'm really amazing that you're all here, especially because it's so early in the morning. I heard that 10 o'clock is really, you know, a bit early. But really great to be here again. And welcome you to the Nextcloud Conference 2018. So this is the biggest Nextcloud Conference we had so far. We have over 200 people. That's just amazing. We're growing every day significantly, every year significantly, every day too. We have people from Kenya, from Brazil, from Japan, from South Africa there, from all kinds of countries. So this is really, really amazing that we have this international big community here of Nextcloud fans and contributors. For the first time, we also have booths outside from other projects. That's really, really good. And we have the most talks and workshops and lightning talks ever. So this is the biggest conference so far. So this is really amazing. Also, I want to take a little step back now and think about it for a second and think about the background, because we all know what the mission of Nextcloud is. So Nextcloud, the goal is to create a decentralized, open source, privacy-aware, security-aware network of clouds, of features. And this is, of course, a bit crazy, because we are trying to challenge the big guys here. We are really, us here in the room and everybody else in the community, we are so, a bit crazy enough that we think we can actually challenge Google and Facebook and Apple and Microsoft and so on. And this is, of course, remarkable, especially because we are growing all the time. So more and more people think that this is actually possible. There's this one quote that I really like. It basically means that we all have to realize that everything around us, and this is especially true for the internet, for cloud services, everything around us is not done by nature or not by some kind of holy law or something. This is all done by other people like us. So other engineers and other enthusiastic people like us actually built this data silos that exist today on the internet. And this also means that we can also challenge it. So we actually have a chance, we actually have a shot to change the world here and to come to a future where everything is a little bit more decentralized and a little bit more open source and a little bit more privacy and security aware. So this is something that unites us here, I think. And yes, it is a big goal, but I'm really convinced that it is possible to reach, and I think we can actually do it. Okay, so what happened since last year? What happened since the last conference a year ago? And I digged into some statistics, and actually a lot. For example, if you look into the server repository in GitHub alone, this is only one of many repositories, as most of you know. It's the main repository, but there are a lot more of them. And we have 2,500 pull requests alone in the server repository. So this is a pull request is usually like a new feature or improvement or a bug fix, then a change. And this is really a lot. You can think if you divide this by 365 days of the year, this is really a lot of activity. We did 20 server releases in the last 12 months. I mean, some of them were major releases, some of them were minor bug fix releases, but 20, that's a lot. We did 25 iOS releases. So Marina here, you're a bit crazy. that's really a lot of releases, a lot of work. So really cool. Thank you. And the Android team, a little bit less releases, but of course then the same amount of features and activity, and it's really, the Android community is really super active with a lot of contributors. And overall, we now reached over 1,800 contributors to the Nextcloud project. And that's really a big number. We really have to realize that we are one of the biggest open source projects out there. There are not a lot of other projects that have over 1,800 contributors. So this is really a big number. Okay, so what are all these pull requests? What is all these changes? What are all the commits? What did all the people do? So of course, we worked on the software and improved things. And because of that, I'm really happy that today we can announce the next major version. So the next major version of Nextcloud, it's the successor of Nextcloud 13. And we have a really amazing marketing team. And I heard that you went to a mountain retreat with a lot of meditation and brainstorming for lots of weeks to think about what could be the name of the successor of Nextcloud 13. Right, so a lot of crazy work, and even some drugs were involved, I heard, I don't know. And really, I'm really happy that you come up with a really good idea. And of course, the name is 14. So, so I'm really happy that we can announce Nextcloud 14 today. So this is a really big release. So I just did a little bit of a rough overview, and these are some of the features and improvements that went into that. I don't think we have the time to go over all of them, but I think we can focus on five main areas. So five areas that I think are especially interesting and important, and I want to go through those five areas now. The first area is design accessibility. So this is something where I'm especially happy about, because one of the missions of Nextcloud is, of course, that is software that's very secure and self-hosted, but it has to be end-user friendly. This is why I'm happy that we have such a accessibility and design and UI and UX focused team here. And for that, I want to ask Jan to present these improvements.
Hello. So first of all, I'm only here as a representative of our whole design team, everyone who works on design, on front end, and also all of you developers who are very design minded. So I'd like to have another great applause for you all. Okay, and so I'd like to show you a few major things that we worked on during this release. And one of the biggest ones, which I'm very happy about, is actually accessibility. So we have, for example, we have these accessibility settings, but that's not the only thing. We also improved the accessibility overall. So for example, keyboard navigation in the whole app is now much easier. Like, you can tab through everything and you can activate everything via enter. And we're continuously developing it. We're continuously making it better. And there's been a lot of help from the community improving that. And we're also testing it more. So if you want to get involved there, if you know more about this, if you use screen reader software, for example, your help is much appreciated. And we have a lot of these settings like high contrast theme, or also a nerdy dark theme that a lot of you will like, which is currently in beta. And so please, if you want to get involved, help out there. Then another thing is a simplified navigation. So we have broken it down, basically. Previously, we had all this share stuff in there, all the different topics. But now we broke it down to just all files, recent, favorites, shares, and tags. And you can open it to reveal more. So for example, favorites, we now show all the folder favorites directly in the navigation. And since you know that already, since a few releases, we sort the favorites up top in every view, so they're always relevant and available. And so it's much simpler in the beginning, but then when you open it, it also stays open and it remembers what you had opened. So it kind of adapts to what you need. Then another really nice detail is the @mention avatars. So now when you mention a person, you have this avatar next to it and you have it nicely contained. And so you see whenever a person is mentioned, and that's just a really cool small detail that I really love. And then there was a lot of settings restructuring, and this is only one of the screenshots that I could show you. So we have the personal page. We have, for example, a new locale setting that we needed for calendar. We have an admin overview page, and as you know, we have these privacy settings for your personal details, but a lot of work is always going into the settings to make it make them make sense and have them sorted the way that they make sense and that they're in the proper categories. And that even the settings, even though we don't have so many settings, luckily, even that they are sorted in a proper way. Then another thing is the user management. It was basically completely rewritten, and it's now much more responsive, and it loads quicker, and it handles users much quicker. Adding users is much easier. You can directly add them with their email address, for example, and it's much less hassle to add people there. And the last thing is standardization. So we did a lot of standardization work of all these different aspects that we're doing in the main apps so that your developers can also use that. And you basically just use the design documentation and the different elements to just make it look like a Nextcloud app. So it's very simple for the developers too. And that's basically all of the design or the design things I want to highlight. So another great applause, please, for the design team and everyone working on that.
Thanks. Thanks, Jan, and our whole design team, of course. You might think there's only small details here and there, but this is really important for end users because, as you know, Nextcloud has the goal to actually get a lot of normal users, not like IT experts, as probably most in this room here, but really normal users. And this UI work is so, so important. So thanks for that. The second thing I want to highlight are improvements in sharing and collaboration. You might think, collaboration, what do I mean with that? Well, from a strategic perspective, I see the world a little bit like that. You could say that something like Nextcloud is in its core something like a file server, right? It's like you have files and you can put them in and get them out and so on. But of course, this is the ancient history. Nowadays, something like that is called file sync and share. This is a term that Gartner created like a few years ago. And this means that there are additional functionality for offline syncing, for sharing links, for mobile access, for web access, and so on. So this is usually called the file sync and share market. But we think that this is not the end of the road, and the next step is collaboration. So it's great that you have access to all your files, but you want to do something with the files, edit them and view them and all kinds of additional things. So this is collaboration. I'm really... and I used this for a few months already, this slide here, and it's funny that just a few weeks ago, also Gartner, they renamed their market to Content Collaboration Platform, which is maybe a little bit of a strange word, but I also think that collaboration is the future. So this is also where we focus on. So a few improvements in this area, and they're from very small to very big. The first thing is a new feature in sharing, where you can... add a note to the share recipient here directly in the menu. I don't know, the Nextcloud users here, you probably know the situation that you want to share a file with someone, and you can, of course, directly Nextcloud share a file very easily, but then you usually send a second mail to the person and say, by the way, I shared a file with you, and this is the reason why, or this is what you should do, or this is what it is. And that's, of course, a bit stupid. So now you can directly type in the share dialogue also a message, and this is in the mail that the recipient gets, and it got a notification, and this is much more streamlined collaboration process here. The next thing is improvements in the sidebar. As Jan already showed, we have this sidebar that's collapsible here, and in the share area, of course, you can filter by shared with others and shared with you and so on. And there's this new entry, deleted shares, pending shares. So you can actually, when you delete the share, it goes in there, and from there you can recover it back. So this is, just easier to handle. And because in the past you have to ask the original person, hey, I accidentally deleted the file, can you please share it again with me? And this is better now. The next thing is we completely restructured, and this is also UI improvement, of course, restructured the overall sharing user interface. So this is an example of the options that you see with a share link, and it's just a lot easier than in the past. I don't know if you imagine the old menu, it was actually a little bit harder to understand, and here this is a lot more straightforward and better. The next thing, this is a more technical topic, is Open Cloud Mesh. So Open Cloud Mesh is an initiative to create a standard for federated sharing across different file sync and share solutions. So I think we as Nextcloud, we are the pioneers here. Björn, who is not here, invented the very first version of the sharing API that we use now for many years, and other projects use the same. But there is this initiative called Open Cloud Mesh, and this is pushed forward by CERN and by Xiant and some other organizations, including us, of course, to create a real standard, to get a real official standard. And this, the API went through a review process with a professional company that's doing API design, and this is a real standard process. And I'm happy to say that we are the first project or the first software that actually implements this standard. So in Nextcloud 14, we are the very first that implements Open Cloud Mesh API. And this is additionally to the old API, so we are still backwards compatible. Okay. But this API is not only prettier, it also has more functionality. So another reason why we did this is because we will use this in the future for other features like federated calendars, for federated video calls, for federated chat messages, and so on. So it's very extensible. So this is only the first step here. Okay, then the next topic is global scale, and specifically federated group shares. So this is another thing that we could implement because of the Open Cloud Mesh API, that you can also do federated group shares, which means I can actually share a file or a folder with a complete group on a different server. So this is a new feature that it didn't exist before. First of all, it is useful to collaborate with people on other machines, but it's especially useful for us for the global scale architecture. The global scale architecture is an architecture where you can have a Nextcloud instance distributed over different hosting centers. And in the past, it came with some functionality restrictions. For example, group shares were not possible, and this is solved now. So with Nextcloud 14, you can also do federated group shares. So these are some improvements, and there are a lot more in the area to make sharing more powerful, more useful, and there's a lot more. We'll talk about a few things later, but this is a very important area for us. The third thing I want to talk about are clients. So this is something that's interesting because, I don't know, I and others, we tend to look at the web interface. I mean, I showed you just many screenshots of our web interface just now. But when we talk to users of Nextcloud, some of them say, well, I never use the web interface. Never. Because the clients are so good. I can do everything with the clients. So this is why we also think that there should be a focus on really good clients and also have a lot of functionality. This is why I want to go through some improvements we did in the client area here. The first is the iOS client. I talked with Marino. I think those are just some of the big improvements from the last 6 months. So really, really a lot. First of all, it's of course we implemented the end-to-end encryption, as you know. That's a feature we announced earlier. So this is now fully supported here, fully working in iOS. The second thing is document provider. This sounds, it's a boring term, but this is actually very cool because this means that Nextcloud is a first-class citizen in the iOS file management. So in the file manager from iOS, there is just Nextcloud is directly in there. You don't even have to open the Nextcloud app itself. It's just directly in the file manager. From there, you can open, save, every application can save in there and open from there and can delete and you can basically do everything same as with Apple iCloud. It's really in the same level of functionality here. So you're really first-class citizen in iOS here. And I think we are also like the first project of our kind, which has this deep integration. Then, yeah. Next thing is push notifications. Just a few weeks ago, we got push notifications, which means I actually got a notification on my phone if someone mentions me in the comments, as Jan showed earlier with the auto-completion. You can mention someone and the phone beeps and you see what's happening. Or if you a new server version is available, or if you get a federated share invite, or if running out of quota or something else, you actually get nice push notifications, which is really nice. And you can also see the activities. Media streaming is very cool. You can actually, if you click on a very big file, a video file, for example, you can actually skip around and it only loads the right pieces. It's very, very good to watch videos and other big files. And server theming is something I personally find very cool. So if you change colors and stuff on the server, it automatically updates also the app. So that your iOS app changes color if you change the color on the server. That's also, personally find this very cool. Then Android, really also a lot of improvements on the Android side. End-to-end encryption, of course, again, we have this in all clients. Push notifications, of course, activities and comments. Comments is also very nice. You can watch all the, look at all the comments on files. Huge speed improvements lately, very nice. Video streaming and very cool new also trash bin and versioning support. So you can really access the trash bin and the versions of files directly in the Nextcloud app. So there are not a lot of reasons to actually use the web interface. You can do really a lot with the clients. So the last thing I want to mention in the client area is the desktop client. The desktop client, if you follow the history of Nextcloud, then you know that we were not able to do a lot of improvements at the very beginning, but this has changed now. So we have a really super active desktop team with a nice contributor community. And we really do a lot of improvements here. This is, for example, a screenshot of the completely redone share dialog. So this is the share dialog where you can directly share things from your desktop. And the layout with the drop-down menu and everything is actually done that it looks the same or works the same than the web interface. So there is basically a synchronization of the UI between the different clients, the web interface, and the desktop interface. So this is a lot more usable and better now. Next thing is the activities view. This is also improved a lot. And I mean, you could always see, I don't know, if someone uploads or downloads a file, but now we can also show the more advanced actions that Nextcloud can do. For example, you can see that someone wants to talk with you in Nextcloud Talk, wants a video call, or someone invites you to a chat room or something, or some other actions. So this is a lot more interactive, and of course, you can also directly accept and join things directly in the activity view. So this is very nice to get notifications. And there's a lot more, of course, end-to-end encryption, again, in the desktop client implemented. Then working notifications, this is something I personally am really happy about. In the past, it was a bit weird. You get a notification with the text that you have a notification. I don't know, some of you know this. That's a bit useless. Now we actually get the real notification. You actually get a notification which says, hey, you're running out of quota, or someone shared something with you, or there's a new comment or something. So this is actually usable now. And a lot of other UI polish also happen at desktop client. And we are really close to release the next version, the 2.5 version. I heard from the team that there's an updated beta coming in just the next few days. The only problem is at the moment that, I don't know, some server doesn't respond, I don't know. But if this is fixed, then we have a totally usable beta of all these new features out, and I'm really happy about that. Okay, the first area I want to talk about is the app ecosystem. So as you might know, from the very beginning in Nextcloud and before, we had this app concept. We always had these apps like plugins, but we didn't call them plugins because plugins suggest that it's just small extensions. But we see Nextcloud as a real application platform. So this is why we call these apps. And the app ecosystem is something that's really, really important for us. So this is, of course, our app store. I checked it like yesterday. We have over 150 apps in there. So this is really, really a lot, and it's growing all the time. And there are for all kinds of things. Of course, you don't really have to go to the app store because you can do everything from inside Nextcloud itself. And this is the new app management, which was also completely rewritten, similar to the user management as Jan presented. And this is a lot better now. For example, you have this new sidebar where you can see nice screenshots and ratings and change logs and links to web pages and so on. So it's really a lot easier to browse through the apps and find good ones. The search now searches over all categories. The categories were restructured. The app bundles were improved. So it's really a lot of improvements where we think we can help our app developers to make their work more prominent and become really first-class citizens in the Nextcloud ecosystem. And now I want to highlight a few apps that I find especially interesting that were updated lately. The first is, of course, the calendar. So this, as you all might know, is one of the most popular apps we have. And this is making so much progress over the years. It's just amazing. In the last release, there were features like free busy support added. But it's a real enterprise class feature where you can send an invite to someone. And maybe the calendar is not shared, but you can still see if the person has time or not. So it's very nice. And in this release, we added resource booking. So you can book like a meeting room or a company car or something directly from inside your calendar. And I really have to say that there is not a lot missing to that this is a real exchange killer, a real, really professional grade groupware here. So we're working on this enterprise grade calendar features, and it's really amazing what functionality is there over the years. Next thing I want to highlight is the tech app. This is very interesting because this is a bit of a hidden gem, I think. Not a lot of people might know this, but this is actually a super powerful and super nice application. It's a Kanban-style project management tool, and it's really, really nice that, for example, customers of the Nextcloud GmbH, they come to us and they really say, hey, we want to use this DAG app in production for our company, and we want to have support for that, we want to pay for that, and we want to pay you to add new features. So I know that Julius lately added some additional features for customers like direct file upload and so on. So this is really, really getting more and more popular. And we will also officially, as Nextcloud, support this in the future. The next thing is, of course, Collabora Online. This is a tool to do collaborative document editing in the browser. And we have, of course, very close relations to the Collabora guys for many, many years. And in this area, we also do a lot of improvements. So we are super close to release new features, like a file picker, for example. In the past, if you ever want to insert a picture into a document, you first had to download the picture from your Nextcloud to your desktop, and then in Collabra, then upload it again and add it into the document, which is of course not optimal. In the future, you can directly from inside Collabra pick a file from Nextcloud, and you can also share documents directly from inside Collabra, and we do a lot more improvements, speed improvements, and other things together. So this is getting better all the time. But I'm also happy to say that we have a second option now. This is only Office, and this is a solution which has similar capabilities than Collabra, different in some areas, sometimes can do more, sometimes less, but it's a similar solution. And this existed for some time already as a community-maintained app, but I'm happy to say that from now on, only Office is also like an official partner from us and really officially support this together. So if you need collaborative document editing, you have two options now you can choose. Okay, then the last thing, no, not the last, one before, I want to show some cool apps in the app ecosystem around GDPR compliance. The GDPR, as you know, is these new data protection requirements. And there are some cool apps available that make this possible. For example, to add a terms of service link to the login page, or to have a terms of service that you have to approve before you can download a file, or in the screenshot here, that a user can request to have data exported, or data or the account deleted. These are all requirements that might not be necessary for you on your private instance, but this is for companies and service providers, that's important to be GDPR compliant. So there are all kinds of apps to enable that, which I find also very cool. The last thing I want to show is this dashboard. This is an app that exists for a while, but it was a little bit rough at the beginning, and it was completely rewritten just a few weeks ago, and this is now really nice. You can have all these different widgets that you can place there, and there's a new API available where all kinds of apps can create these widgets, and you can then show them here. So this is also something that's quite popular. Okay. So the last area I want to highlight now is Nextcloud Talk. So Nextcloud Talk that's a really special and really amazing project. It is a communication solution, so it's a chat and video call solution. This is less than a year old. I mean, this is just, if you look at the functionality that's already there, this is really amazing. Of course, 1 year old is not the complete truth, because we're building on top of all the experience of Spreed, which was a previous solution. So we are not reinventing everything, but the code is completely new and the concept is a bit different. And this is really nice now. You might think that, okay, why do I really need this? I use like Signal or Telegram or Threema or something. There are a few things fundamentally different with Nextcloud Talk, and I think a lot better. First of all, it is 100% open source. So the server component, all server components are open source. The iOS app and the Android app are also open source. So this is not the case with these other messengers and video call apps. And second thing, as important, is of course all self-hosted. Right? You can just, with one click in the app management, click on Talk, and then you have it running on your local instance, and you basically have your own chat system, your own video call telephone system locally available, and this doesn't exist anywhere else. But this is quite unique. And of course, we have the full Nextcloud integration. You can use all your same login and the same web interface and notifications and so on. So this is quite nice. This is a screenshot of the chat interface. This is a group chat here. So you can chat, you can mention people and get notifications. You can invite people, and that people can be from the same instance, or you can also send out public links to someone. These public links can also be password protected or not. So you can, if you have an internal chat or something, invite an external person to also join the channel. That's possible, of course. And you can also press the call button on top, and then this turns into a video call, video call with multiple people. Actually, the number of people is not really limited from a software perspective. There are some limitations in from bandwidth and CPU need, which makes it practical or not. But there are ways to scale it really up to lots and lots of users if with the right backend. And we have some talk about this later with more details. And of course, screen sharing. Here you have screen sharing, which is also available. So something I find really nice about Talk are our mobile apps. So here you see the Android app and the iOS app. And one of the cool things is that these apps are fully feature complete with the web interface. So there's nothing you can do in the web interface that you can't do on mobile. So you don't really have to use the web interface if you don't want to. You can download those apps. They are obviously completely open source. They are for free in the app stores. And then you can do everything there as you do with Signal and Threema and Telegram, but talking to your own server. That's very, very nice. So those are the five main areas that I wanted to highlight. Design improvements, accessibility, sharing, collaboration, clients, app ecosystem, Nextcloud Talk. So a lot of improvements all over the place for Nextcloud 14. So if you hear all these announcements, all these features, some deck and calendar and talk and mail and things, you might think, this is a lot. This is a lot what you're doing here. And some people, they come to us and say, hey, why do you do all those things? Why don't you concentrate on file sync and share? You're doing too much. So the reason we are doing this is because I really believe that this belongs together. These features, they really belong together. There's so much options for synergies and for nice collaboration that we think that this really belongs together. And it's not only our opinion. I mean, if you look at what Office 365 is doing for Microsoft, it's exactly the same. They have all these tools that are connecting closer and closer. Google Suite, Google Apps, they're the same, right? They also have different components, but they work together. This becomes one big suite for everything. And even, as I said before, Gartner, as a research company, also called as a collaboration market now, also thinks that these things belong together. So we really think that it's different components that really belong together. And I want to show you some examples that I haven't mentioned before that demonstrate how this all fits together. This is why we are doing this. The first is, this is a screenshot from the sharing dialog. And here you have Morris here with an avatar, and we use the avatars in more and more places, as Jan showed earlier. The thing is, with every avatar in Nextcloud, you can actually click on the avatar, and then you get this menu. And then you can directly, for example, send a mail to Morris, and if you use the Nextcloud mail app, then it automatically opens, and you can write a mail there, and if not, then this is normal mail tooling, which means your native mail application opens. And you can also directly start a video call. From everywhere in Nextcloud, you can directly call or chat with a person. And this is very nice because maybe you see a comment, or somebody did a change of a document, or you're working together on a document and you want to talk to the person, then this is very, very easy. So it's all integrated. Second is, here in the share dialog, again, I typed in ENG, and I get this auto-completion here, and this auto-completion is actually a chat room. So you can, when you want to share a file, you can share a file directly into a chat room. And that's very nice, because everybody in the chat room then gets this link directly placed into the Nextcloud, and you can then work together on those things. And it's even so clever that if you later add more people, they also then get the file. So really have the connection of files and a discussion and a video call, and maybe in the future more. So this is all nicely integrated. You can imagine how this could work, right? You have a discussion around a customer project or your wedding or whatever, and then during the discussion, where's this picture, or can I collaborate on this document or something? You can just type in, go to documents, they are shared in the channel, and then everybody in the channel gets the document, and you can talk about it, or maybe click on it, and of course then collaborate work collaboratively together on the document. So this is all fits very nicely together. Another example is the Outlook plugin we have. So this is a nice feature where you, when you send a big attachment in a mail, then you have this plugin installed. It's automatically in background uploaded to Nextcloud, and the share link is generated, and the share link is put into the mail. So this is, again, then you use also Nextcloud together with mail. Another mail feature, and this is a bit the other way around, is this feature. This is a feature, an app that you can install, and it works like that, that every attachment you get by mail automatically is automatically placed into a folder in Nextcloud. So every attachment you get, you connect it to your IMAP server, and every attachment you get is automatically placed in this server and in this folder. And of course, you have your desktop client, you automatically download it, and you can search them and so on. So it's also very nice that integrates email workflows with file sync and share workflows. Okay, but there's one last feature I wanted to show, because this is a bit special and very unique. I don't think it exists anywhere else. So for this feature, we created actually a very nice video that demonstrates it. You can watch it on our website later today. I can't show it here because of audio problems, but I can explain what it is, of course. So video verification is a solution for the following problem. If you want to share a very confidential file with someone, you can, of course, generate a share link and send the share link to this person. But at the end of the day, you send it by mail to some mail account. You really don't really know who this mail account belongs to, who is on the other side, who is reading the mails. It could be the sysadmin, it could be someone else who is using the same PC, the kid who is playing with the smartphone, I don't know. And if it's really needed, that a special document really reaches exactly one person and no one else, then this is something that's really hard to do with just sending a share link to someone. Of course, you can protect it with a password, but the same problem, right? You have to get this password and also to someone, and you don't really know who gets this password. So this is a challenge that others solved. For example, in Germany, there's this post-ident verfahren. This is some of you might know, this is a system where you have to go to the post office, you have to show your passport, and the person compares the face on the passport with the person there, you have to sign a document, and then it's basically certified that you're really that person. In other cases, like with GPG, for example, this is done with key signing. All right, you have this key that's associated to an email address, but you don't really know that this key is also actually owned by this person. This is why you have these key signing parties, where you basically match keys to people. And this is a problem that is not really solved in file sync and share so far. But we think we have a nice solution here with video verification. So it works like that, that in the sharing dialogue, there is this new option, which is called Password Protect by Talk. And I can just go there. This is a very confidential document. And I can click this button, and I choose a password that I type in here. And then this share link is sent to this person by mail. And this person then clicks on the link, and the browser opens. And then you basically see that. You type in the password here that you don't know, but you can press the request password button. And if you do that, the sidebar opens with a video call to the person who shared the file. Okay? So you can actually, the phone of this person rings, because we have, as discussed, push notifications for Nextcloud Talk, right? Your phone rings, you answer the phone, then you have a video call to the person who got the link, and you say, okay, hey, how are you? Do you recognize the person? Yes, this is the guy that I mean. And then you tell them the password. This is the password, 123. Type in the password, and then you have access to the document. So this is a way to verify to not share to an email address, to really share to a person. But this is very, very unique. So this is the last feature I wanted to show, which shows why we integrate all those nice tools together. And this is also fully working now in Nextcloud 14, of course. So because of that, I really think that we can call Nextcloud the most advanced content collaboration and file sync and share platform, because we have all those improvements in all different areas, and it all fits together. Okay, now is the question, of course, how do people get Nextcloud, right? The Nextcloud, I showed you all this nice functionality, all these nice features, that's great, but how do people get Nextcloud? As I told you at the very beginning, we have these crazy goals to really reach a lot of people on this planet, right? Not only us who can install a Linux package or run a Docker container or something. How do we actually reach a lot of people, like many, many millions, maybe billions of people all over the world? And this is something where we talk a lot and brainstorm a lot around that, and I think we have two solutions for that. So that I want to announce today. So the first solution is called Simple Sign Up. And to talk about that, I want to invite Jos on the stage to tell us what is Simple Sign Up and how does it help to get many, many millions of more users.
Hello. So, I'm Jos, and I have a question for all of you. How many of you think that with the current tech, most people can quite easily run a server at home? There's three really enthusiastic people. I think the rest is slightly more realistic. So with that in mind, let's take a little step back. And Frank already talked about what we're doing here. We're pretty ambitious. I mean, what we're working on, we don't do it just for the people in the room. We don't do it for all the people watching, even though they're all very cool. Hello, everyone there. We do it because we really want to give everyone a chance to take control back over their data. And with everyone, I mean, there are 7 billion people on this planet, and you know, ideally, we would have all data decentralized as much as possible. So where are we today with that? This is in 2015, when Frank gave a keynote also here at the university, and he put up numbers, a rough estimate of how many users there are in Nextcloud. How many people were using a private cloud, and back then he estimated between 2 and 4 million people. Now, I think today, a more realistic number would be between 15 and 25 million, which is, I think, a big improvement. Yeah. That's cool. So last time, when he gave this keynote, everybody also applauded for this slide, because this is a very nice number. And Frank, who never really, you know, let go of an opportunity to, I guess, ruin the mood, then came with this slide. If you can read it, it puts it next to the other players, Google with hundreds of millions, Apple. I mean, if you add up the numbers that are at the big cloud players, Amazon, Google, Dropbox, Apple, we're probably talking about well over a billion. Yeah. So what we're doing together is basically putting all our eggs in one of like half a dozen baskets all over the world. Everybody has their data at one of a handful of huge companies. And I mean, you wouldn't be here probably if you thought that was a good idea. So I'm not going to talk extensively about why it's a bad idea. I think we're all on the same page on this one. The question is, what are we going to do about it? Now, we had in our clients for a long time a way to sign up to Nextcloud, in the sense that there was like a button or a link where you could go to nextcloud.com and you could, download the zip file and then have no idea what to do with it. Or you could go buy a device and then, you know, at home when you got it, you would configure your router if you knew what the router was. Or you could look for a provider. You pick one out of 100 providers. You know, some of them have the data in the mountains in Switzerland, probably very safe from, I don't know, alien attacks. Another one would have like green windmill powered, which always reminds me of a French knight from a long time ago. All kinds of options there. And that's pretty hard for normal people to figure out. What is the right choice for me? how much storage do I need, how much should I pay for it, should I have all SSD storage, daily backups, a lot of options. And once you've made a choice, you have to then figure out, okay, I need to get the technical data, I need to then give the link into the client, then username, password, and then you're logged in and you have your data. How is this at Dropbox, for example, or Google? I mean, to sign up to Dropbox, all you need to do is give your email address and a password. That's quite a bit less work than everything I just was talking about. So we fixed this. It is now just as easy to sign up to Nextcloud and to get a privacy-protecting decentralized cloud as it is to sign up to a centralized cloud. Thank you. So I'm going to show you. If you start up the client and you click on the button sign up, you just have to enter an email address. We pick a provider for you. We pick a provider based on where you are. So it's a matter of distance. If you don't like it, you can change the provider. We don't have to. You can just enter your email address, yeah, and click on the sign up button. Then you give a password and you're logged in. You can start to upload your files right away. Done. There's nothing else to it. It's as simple as that. Email, password, and it's running. You're logged in. So right now we have six providers that we're working with. So I want to do thank you to all of them. Some of them are here. Let's give them an applause for being awesome. So they give 2 gigabytes of data to everyone. Minimum free storage. Some of them give 3, 4, 5. There's a whole bunch of apps available as well. And it's for free, just as with the big cloud providers. So again, you get the same as what you get with centralized cloud, but you actually have a choice. Over time, we will add more providers. We will work with them to make sure that the quality is good, that you can trust them. And again, I mean, here at the conference, several of them are here. You can literally walk over to them, have a chat, and figure out whether you think they're trustworthy or not. If not, come talk to me. I might, you know, do something about it. So now you know where your stuff is. We have a bunch of nice posters and stickers of this because I think it's important to help people figure out where their data is and who has access to it. So please tell everyone that they can now sign up to Nextcloud, even if they're not very technical, if they don't, you know, want to go through the hassle of running their own server or even figuring out what provider they want to pick. It's as easy as it gets. You can go to this page and see your options, or you can just immediately go to nextcloud.com/register, sign up. It's literally email address and a password. It's all you need. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Jos. This is really nice. Of course, we announced this feature like here now on the stage today, but the feature was already active for a few days in our mobile apps in iOS and Android, and will be in the next desktop version, of course, too, and there will be a sign-up button on our website, too. So lots of different ways to sign up, and this, some of them were already online for a few days, mainly for testing, and we already heard from some providers they got like a ton of new users via this channel. I don't know how much, and I don't really want to know anyways, but it really seems to work. People seems to like that. That really solves the problem, as you said, that in the past you downloaded the app, and the first thing you see is, what is the server address? And normal users are like, server address? What is that? I don't know what this is. And then I go away and I use Dropbox. Right, and this is something that we really think we solved here. Okay, so this is the first option, the first way where we think that we get a lot more users for Nextcloud, but there's also a second thing, because this is a way where you can go to a service provider. Of course, it's still a service provider, it's still not you at home, right? It's still a company that you have to trust, but we believe that it's already a lot better if the data is decentralized between, like, I mean, our website, we have over 100 service providers listed already that offer Nextcloud. We were not able to all put them into this program, but over time we get and expect that we have a lot of service providers there. And if the data is distributed over 100 or maybe 1,000 service providers in the future, this is so much better than one data silo at Google. So this is really good. But of course, there's this other way to think about it, where people think, okay, I really, really want to have my data at home. I really want to have my data... Yeah, here in this box, I want to touch it. This is here. This is where it is. I don't trust anyone. Okay, so this is the question. This is the second thing we want to solve. I mean, or at least make progress here to get Nextcloud at home in a very easy way. So if you might know that 2 years ago, I think, also here at the TU, we launched the Nextcloud box. So the Nextcloud box was a project that we did in collaboration with Western Digital Labs and Canonical Ubuntu. It was just a Raspberry Pi with a hard disk and Nextcloud on it. And this was a device that you could buy for including the Raspberry Pi, like $100, depends. And then you can run Nextcloud on it. The thing is, of course, for us, this was always meant as a proof of concept, as a test device, because we definitely don't want to become a hardware company. And we're not in the business of selling hardware. But we did this and we sold like a few hundred of those. How many did we sell, Jos? How many boxes did we sell? 1,500 even. Yeah, yeah. Then they stopped production because, well, for everybody it was just meant as a proof of concept. So there's demand, but we don't become a hardware company here. But this is just a test device that we did because we hoped that other companies that are actually in the hardware business see this and then come up with an idea, yeah, we can do the same. And actually, I'm really happy to announce today that exactly that happened. So we are actually working together with NEC in Japan and with a company called WaffleCell and us, of course, and we are actually doing the same idea, of course, a lot better. I will talk about it in a second. And to really bring it this time to millions of users, not to like 1,500. So the idea is that NEC is one of the biggest home router manufacturer in Japan. They really have millions and millions of customers. Okay, and NEC will put Nextcloud on those home routers. So this is very cool because of a few reasons. First of all, the customer, the end user, they don't really have to pay for it because it just comes as the normal box. It's just a feature. Because the Nextcloud box is, of course, you have to convince normal people on the street that they should pay like $100 for this box when they get everything from Google for free. And in this case, it's also for free because it's just built into the normal router that everybody has at home anyways that they need for their normal internet access. That's the first thing that's really cool. The second is the speed. In Japan, 70% of the people, they have actually fiber channel internet connection with gigabit upstream and downstream. Okay? So these Nextclouds that are deployed by the millions there are actually really fast and really totally suitable for federated collaboration between all those different home routers. You can have shared links and have calls between them and chat between them and so on. And this works super fast and very nice. The next thing that's really cool about that is that all these network configuration problems go away. Because with a device like a Nextcloud box, of course, it's sitting behind your router. You have to configure some kind of port forwarding. You have to configure some dynamic DNS to access it from the outside. All this goes away because it actually runs on the router. So this all works automatically. So this is actually very nice. And we all optimize this, of course, for this federation that you can really share photo galleries with your neighbor in an easy way and everything very nicely decentralized. Because of that, I'm really happy to ask our guest from Japan here on the stage, Mr. Masayoki Note. Thank you. A little bit about this project.
Okay. I'm so happy to be here at Next Cloud Conference 2018. Next Cloud is a great product and great community. I think you can change the world much better. And Next Cloud NEC platforms are manufacturer and Waffle computer that makes this operating system called Waffle Cell are the best partners to make this happen. And I want to tell you something. NEC platforms and Waffle computer is trying to make the network distributed. And this infrastructure is just can't do anything by itself. So we need developers like you guys. And I want you to remember that, just imagine there will be millions of the Next Cloud instances running on the network. I think the world will be much better with your help. Thank you.
Okay, thanks a lot. So those were our announcements for today. So the big summary of this morning is we have Next Cloud 14, which we think is the most advanced file sync and share solution out there, collaboration solution. We have video verification, which is, I think, a solution doesn't exist anywhere else, which is very important if you're a bank or you're a doctor or you're someone who really handles like very confidential document wants to share them. So this is a very unique security feature, doesn't exist anywhere else. Simple sign-up, where we can really bring Nextcloud to a lot more users with the help of our great providers. And then, of course, together with NEC, we can deploy many, many millions of Nextcloud instances at home. So these are the announcements for today. And I'm really happy that Nextcloud evolves so fast because of the community, because of you. And thanks a lot. And I really wish you a great Nextcloud conference. There will be a lot more talks and keynotes and presentations and everything. And Jos will tell you all about the next things that happen and other logistics. Thanks a lot.